السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How to create positive attitude. It's important for us guys, it's not only to give you or develop your hard skills, competences, but also it's important to develop soft skills, which is quite necessary now in market. What I meant by soft skills is communication skills, collaboration skills, establish effective relationship with others, which is quite important. So from this perspective, we discuss today how to create positive attitude for you as students in the college. It can be, it can make wonder, it can make, you know, like paradigm shift. For your thought, for your everyday life, in a way to be succeeded, in a way to be successful or establish success life, and being successful person in the future. So this is quite important. I have for you today, guys, a very important book, which is called What to Say When You Talk to Yourself. A sort of, you know, personal development. We call it in Arabic Tanmiyah Bashariyah. So this is as well help you somehow to create a positive attitude towards yourself, towards your study, towards people around you. It started from yourself, it started from you as a person. So this is, here we are, let us go. We will go through through many stuff here. And let us start first with the learning objective. So by the end of this lesson, guys, you will list the five levels of self-talk. How you speak to yourself. Speaking to yourself is not sort of madness or being crazy or whatever. It is really, from scientific point of view, is very important. It's not only to talk to yourself verbally as well. It's talking to yourself, it is managing your thought, which is non-stop, you know, activities over the day and night. So list the five level of self-talk. Adapt an approach for changing the habits and attitude. Bad habits, those who are smoker, those who are, you know, long sleeping, those who are do not care. So we need to change this to a positive attitude. I will help you during this lecture to take a step for changing your life, for improving your existence. So third one, develop vocabulary of self-talk for everyday life. To change your belief, to change your attitude, to change your feelings, so we need to create sort of positive statement, positive conversation to deal with everyday life, or to develop and to build up and adapt for yourself to be this is a new perspective for yourself, about yourself first and about the others second. Okay, so let us go through this. We have here some issues. Probably you ask yourself all the time, or you talk to yourself negatively as, I cannot do it, it's impossible, it's bad. So you see people around you is more likely to complain. They are a complainer, or they are you know, negative, or they are whatever, has no will to do anything. So you know exactly to keep away from such. Because as we said in Arabic, "Tur ala ashkalia taqa." If you go through, if you combine such people, you will be the same. You will be exactly the same. But if you combine those who are achiever, who are just, you know, have strong will, those who are positive, who are just those who has ambition in this life, so you will be the same as well. So be aware with this. So be aware with this. Okay. So this issue we need to eliminate. We need to overcome this problem. This is why I'm coming during this lecture, telling you exactly about the a new technique you could adapt for your daily life. So let us go. Here we are. So human behavior, how does the brain work? So it's important for us as well, guys, to know how your brain works. And now, currently, there is neuroscience, and the neuroscience, this is new like field which study the function of brain, how brain works, and it helps us as educator, as for you as learner as well, to know exactly which strategy fit to your brain, which strategy help you quickly and efficiently to learn without losing information, without forget anything, and all of these ideas. So let us tell what author about this book tells us. The author tells us about you cannot get anyone to do anything that they don't want do not want to do without forcing. So one of these issue as well, so you have to as educator, as students as well, you have to stuff, or as a parent as well, you have to stuff to ask your kids if you want them to do something, whether to convince them or speak to them in a way of communication, and as well in a way of convincing, peer-to-peer conversation, or you use a stick and the carrot. Stick and the carrot, this is what we call this punishment. If you do not do it, we will punish you. This, so sort of forcing to do something, which is ineffective at some point. Here he said about advertising as well, that they play on subconscious of your brain, which you cannot control at all. And if you control your subconscious here, you will learn better, you will change your attitude. And this is why a lot of advertisement works on this level, and it control your thought without being controlled from yourself. He told as well about 148 no's during your raising your parents all the time. Whatever you request from them, they say no. You will never do it. You will not do it. You are a failure. You are a loser. You. So you already absorb a lot of, you know, negative thoughts during your life, and as well effectively impact the brain how they think. And the neuroscience tells us as well that when you raise in such a negative environment or a stressful environment, so your brain more likely to release cortisol, which can affect, you know, all of your brain. When your brain already emerged with cortisol, this hormone stress, it's hard later to get rid of it. It's possible as well, but as well it hurts you. It leaves you with some damage in your brain, which affect your behavior in the future, affect your self-esteem and self competences. So he said as well, 75 negative thinking programming cortisol hormone, what our life works against us. So as we said, more negative, more cortisol in your brain, more negative, being negative in the life. Repetition is convincing argument. He said as well, as we said in Arabic, التكرار يعلم الشطار. We said here as well, if you repeat positive thinking in everyday life in your brain at some point will believe it. So your brain is like you feed your brain, and your brain reply about your feeding. So you feed your brain positive, he will reply positive. You feed your brain negative, he will reply negative. So this is why he said there is no absolute fact or true fact in this life, or true reality of this life. It's everybody has his own based on the perspective he look at the life surrounded. He said as well here, as a man thinks, so he is. This is from from old religion book. So the end result of your thought, or you are the end result of your thought. If you are positive, so if you think positive, you will be positive guy. If you think negative, you will be negative guy. Your success or failure is in anything large or small will depend on your programming, what you accept from others, and what you say when you talk to yourself. So basically, guys, it starts from you, start from yourself. So what you think about yourself, you will think about others. If you self compete person, so you will be trusted for others. If you self-trusted person, so others will trust you. It's mutual as well. So started from from you, how you program your brain, how you speak to yourself, what your thought tells you about yourself, and every day you cannot do it, no, just have a rest, you will never achieve anything, you will be lazy, you just sleep, or no, I will do it, we can do it, I will try, at least I will learn something new, I will have new experience, no lose at all, anyway, we take the reason and Allah will give success for us, so you will be positive as well. More you program your brain, more you will create positive attitudes around you. So being positive is the key. The brain simply believe what you tell it most, and what you tell it about you, it will create, as we said. So protection and recovery, it's important for you guys to go through this, and this is the key to create positive attitude. So here we are. Let us go the next point is 30 years how to be successful. The guy of this book actually he did for us make content analysis, and he collect a lot of message from personal development book, which we call the Tanmiyah al-Bashariya, and he reached out with many statements. We go through them one by one, which is important for us. But he said that all of this based on external factor. That means somebody will teach you, somebody will train you, somebody will tell you to do something. So use something external for yourself. He said it's quite okay, but it's ineffective. It's not really remain for long time. Which remain for long time is internal stuff, internal changing, internal convincing, internal thought, internal approach you do with yourself. Anyway, let us go through external stuff, what he collected from other book, to go through it one by one. So he said, for example, here, believe in yourself, keep your priorities straight, take responsibility of yourself, create your own future, focus on what you want, learn to visualize the outcome of your goal, never let anyone control your destiny for you, be creative, think big, control stress, be aggressive and assertive, think positively, chart your own course, set specific goals and review them often, improving your mind daily, review your result and readjust as necessary, be tolerant, do everything with love, do not hate, have courage, recognize that most of what you believe about life is illusion, be honest, work hard, believe money is good and will come to you, if you agree to do it, enjoy it, have faith, be strong, show affection, passion, manage yourself, time, dress right, learn to sell yourself, take time off, believe in higher self, eat right, live prudently, seek and the aid of others who are in sympathy with you, with your goal, give assistance to others, keep motivated, mediate, be optimistic, trust others and be worthy of trust, recognize that success is more than money, be kind, see the big picture, take care of the detail, get organized, don't procrastinate, stay in control, keep fit, see problem as opportunities, learn everything you can about your job, do not afraid of success, be generous to others, believe in God, reach a little higher than you thought you could, set your sights, take actions, never give up. And this is a guy collected from different book of personal development. Okay, it's very nice and it's great. Okay, some of them based on your internal stuff, which is powerful. This is what we need to focus. And some of it based on external stuff, which is partly help, but it's not the big issue. So, however, he described all of this and listed for us out. Still, we need to know his perspective about how to speak to yourself in a way to change yourself. Let us go through it. So, he he speaks here about talk to yourself like you would to someone, like you would to someone you love. This is as well, Brené Brown said it. So self-talk as an internal way based on function of the brain that work. Here we are going, guys, to know exactly his perspective. So let us go by one by one. So first of all here, changing all the programming. So first point of self-talk here, what author tells us, changing all the programming. What other teacher friends said about you? For example, you in primary school or middle school, teacher said to you, "You are stupid. You have no future." And try to clean it out. Huh? We are creative. We are unique. Allah created us unique. Huh? And وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ Allah said in the Quran. So this is, guys, is facts, and nobody stupid. This is as well, it's not proper word to say about any human being. Everybody has his own talent, has a sort of intelligence, and so on. So what other teacher, parent, so leave it behind you. Be surrounded with new inspiration, passion, and motivation. Surround yourself. For example, if you listen to all bad news, if you open negative magazine or something very bad, you will be the same. You will be the same because this is the motivation energy you surround yourself with. On the other hand, if you surround yourself with positive stuff, inspiration, motivation, watch something really inspire you, motivate you to create something, to be good, to be, you will be the same. You will be the same. And all of these guys, this is sort of programming. You program yourself in everyday life. In everyday life, look to your friend with who you are working, with who you are combined, make company. With who you eat, with who you share life, you'll be the same. You'll be the same. Whether he's positive, you'll be positive. He's negative, complainer, you'll be the same. So this is the first programming. See around yourself, find motivation, inspiration. Changing bad habit and avoid self-doubt into self-directed mind. Take responsibility about yourself. And know that nobody will help you than yourself. Understand it. You are the only person who will help yourself. We have been trying to achieve our goals with our own onboard computer program to hold us back. As he said, this negative attitudes you have, try to replace it. This is the first step. So how brain works. Brain works based on neurotransmitters, that there is some hormones released by brain. For example, oxytocin, hormone of love, dopamine, cortisol, whatever, serotonin, all of these neurotransmitters. Every one has its function. Biochemical electrical impulse thought it looks like in the brain biochemical electrical impulse. Upbringing programming creates belief creates attitudes. He said like this: if you want to change anybody's behavior, there is stairs you should go through it. There is structure you should go through it. First, in order to change behavior, you need to change feeling. In order to change feeling, you need to change attitude. In order to change attitude, you need to change belief. In order to change belief, you need to change the way you speak to yourself. This programming your mind. So this is the stairs you go through it in order to change yourself. And this is what we are going to determine all of these stuff. So create new programming for yourself. Health positive and productive. Learn how to talk to yourself. Speak to yourself. Yeah, you'll do it. Yeah, I will do it. You, nobody better than me. We are. I can do it. I can try at least. I will gain a lot of experience. I will never lose anything. All of this is added experience to myself. Always tell yourself positive stuff. Always encourage yourself to do something, to take advantage, take more risks in life, learn more, invest time, invest even money, lose part of money for investing, for learning. You never learn without paying, paying time, paying energy, paying money, and treat it as sort of learning, not losing, sort of learning. The longer you have bought the thought, the truer it is. The human brain will do anything possible you tell it to do, if you tell it often enough and strongly enough. So repeat on your brain. He will believe it. خلاص. You are self-worthy and worthy trust, and as well you are self-esteem, and you will do whatever you want. You are smart, intelligent. Tell yourself you are handsome. You are whatever. Just get around you. Grab positive energy around you. It will create you as positive. This is no joke. It's fact. The programming part of your brain makes your moral judgment. It simply accepts what you tell it, as we said. The mechanic that you never sleep, subconscious. It's always like this. It's not only what you are aware, but there is something below your subconscious level of it. As advertisement already bought you honey or toxic in honey, as we said, normally in Arabic, you put the in acid. So they want you to push you to buy something, and they bought you something related to your basic need, related to your self-esteem, related to your love or community, whatever, from these basic needs, and you buy the, finally you will buy it. So self-made wall of negative. If we go about self-made, normally you speak to yourself all of these bad words in everyday life. For example, it's going to be another one of these days. It is just not use. I just know it wouldn't work. Nothing ever goes right for me. That is just my luck. I am so clumsy. I don't have a talent. I am just no creative. I cannot see to get organized today. Just it's my isn't my day. I already know I wouldn't like it. Another blue Monday. That really makes me mad. I am not good in math. Nobody like me. All of this negative. All of this negative. Talk to you, speak to yourself. Be aware with this and eliminate this. Why you destroy yourself? Why you make yourself negative? What benefit you will have by the end? You will destroy your positive energy around you. By the end, you will fail because you believe that you will fail. You tell yourself all the time. You tell your brain all the time that I'm going to fail. I will fail, and you will fail by the end. But if you tell yourself I will be succeeding. I am searching about success. I will do something this year. I will create something new. I will learn something new. You will learn. You will change. You will be better. So it's up to you guys. So the main idea of this is change this. Change the bad attitudes normally you do. So second point is talking to friends. More about problems than about exciting potential. Look to yourself in everyday life. Which topic you speak to your colleague when you come to the college? It was a bad day. Exam was so difficult. I have enough of this college. I will not do anything. I quit. I will drop out. I will go from this college. I will not continue. All of this you speak from your colleagues, and you listen to each other. You program each other negatively, of course. So no future for this. No future for this. What for? What for? If you select to be in such area, like it. So if you select to do something, enjoy it. So this is the logic. This is how to develop and improve yourself. So self-management sequences. So nothing in our life happen accidentally, rather it happen on what we mentally create to happen. It's like you plan for something. You plan for something. When you plan for something, you are going to do it. Exactly the same. If you program your mind that you will fail, by the end you will fail. If you program your mind that you will succeed, you will succeed by then. So it's all about you guys. It's all about programming. It's all about how you see, how you put glass, positive or negative glass on your eyes to see the world through. Okay, so five steps that control our success. As we said, we start from programming our mind. If we program our mind with positive stuff, we create belief. We create positive belief. When we create positive belief, we'll have positive attitude. Attitude. And when we have positive attitude, we'll have positive feeling. Positive feeling. Normally, when you take any decision in your life, you have, we called it gut feeling. German say, Bauchgefühl. Normally, study tells us that you don't use too much cognitive skills to take skill to take decision. Rather, you rely on feeling. You rely on gut feeling. So this is very important to take decision. So to take decision, you have to feel good. You have to feel good. And neuroscience tells us the part responsible about feeling and the emotion on the brain controls a part of cognition. That means feeling is more dominant part on the brain than cognition. So this is give you the how important feeling and emotion. And by the way, emotion is subconscious part of the brain and the feeling is conscious part of the brain. So this is the difference between feeling and emotion. So here we are. If you change your feeling and you feel good, you will take decision directly and you'll take action and the behavior will be changing. So this is the stairs of changing your life, based on programming your brain first. Remember this. So, five level of self-talk. We have negative and positive. If you see negative, so negative acceptance, recognition, and need to change. And if we see positive, so you can see decision to change, the better you it is, start with it is. So this is somehow how it works. Okay. Motivation. About motivation, external motivation, it doesn't last, as I said to you. If you rely on external motivation, that's people that you study because salary, you study because job, you study because your father expected from you to study, you will never be convinced. You will never learn anything because it is, you know, external stuff pushing you to do it. But what lasts actually, it is internal motivation. Internal motivation, which based on self-talk, you encourage yourself, you are inspired to do something like this. You like what you are doing. You like what you are doing. I like what I'm doing. I like what I'm doing. Repeat it. Your brain will like it. It will believe it. And you will like it. You will like it. This is a programming, what we speak about. He said about difference between self-talk and hypnosis. This تنويم المغناطيسي. This self-talk is not hypnosis because hypnosis affect you by somebody will affect you. Somebody will tell you whatever you do. It's not really active and it's not really last. But self-talk, this is you program yourself. You take responsibility or charge of your mental health and physical health and, you know, spiritual health. Subliminal learning, this is what subconscious of learning, which is really as well, we speak about this before. So about resources here, he meant about resources. Time, energy, time, energy, and mind. This is resource. What you have to change yourself. Time, energy, and mind. Energy, make positive energy around yourself, which change mind is spirit stuff, ruh. So this is with you praying, you make, you know, good stuff, good deeds, help others. This encourage your motivation as well. time, invest time for doing something really good for yourself, and accordingly will be good for others. So bad old habit. So all of us has bad old habit. For example, putting things off, smoking, working too hard, or not working hard enough, are going, ignoring problems, oversleeping, complaining, making excuse. You are better in this, making excuse, huh? Losing things, being sarcastic, whatever. All of this bad habit, all of this negative energy and negative programming you programmed yourself before. And it's time now, guys, to change it, to be better for yourself first. To be better for yourself. You will learn, you will be a different person. You will be a really worthy trust person. Everybody will believe you. You even will gain any argument or any debating, because you gain yourself first of all. And you will never make any good relationship with others unless you make good relationship with yourself by self-talking, by positive self-talking. So this is the main idea. So if we go through habit-changing self-talk, we will give here some examples. The guy tells us about his book. Maybe you can list all of this in a paper, or just record in any voice recorder and listen it all the time. Instead of listening to crap in your car, listen to something really inspire you, improve your... Like, for example, I always do everything I need to do when I need to do it. I never let any emotion work against me. I don't smoke. I have a good memory. If you tell yourself I have good memory, you remember names. You have problems to remember names, to remind yourself about names. You remember face but not names. But because you tell yourself I don't really have good memory names. This is programming. This is you program yourself to not remember. This is a brain listen to this and will not remember. But if you tell yourself I will remember, I am remembering all the time. I have the strong memory ever. You remember this programming. This works in terms of transmitter in your brain. Release dopamine, release motivation transmitters, which encourage and improve cells in your brain. This is biochemical, electrical transaction in your brain. Works in science like this. So it based on the language you give. Feed positive, you receive positive. Feed negative, you receive negative. I am able to achieve any goal which I set for myself. All of this is very important. So this is a habit change. He gave us example as well about attitude change, self-talk. If you want to change attitude, you would say, I take full responsibility of everything about me. I always meet all obligation which I accept. There is no they on whom I let the blame. Huh? I have learned that they is me. I'm responsible about this. Like other guys said, he said something very interesting. He said, I am myself. He called Ortega Gazette. I just put it here on my desk. I am myself and my circumstance. So he take charge of his own responsibility, and he put himself in charge of himself. So take the responsibility and improve yourself. So the guy gave us example of self-talk for self-esteem. If you want to increase your self-esteem as well, it's possible. You can program yourself. Put this statement on your door or on your mirror, or record it and listen to it. I really am very special. I like who I am and I feel good about myself. I am unique from the top of my head to bottom of my feet. I am me. I am positive, I am confident. Look, positive stuff. Program your brain. Solving problem. If you face a lot of problem, and there are a lot of problem around you, no human being live without problem. I am good at solving problem. I like challenge. I meet them head on. Look, challenge, conquer, solution, and win are words which I live by daily. I am always on time. On time, don't come late to the class. I am in control of my feeling, my emotion, my attitudes and my needs. I control them. They do not control me. Look how the language, how positive language we have. You have as well motivation self-talk. Motivation self-talk as well, if you want to motivate yourself, I can do anything. I can do, I have a talent, skills, and ability. I set goals and I reach them. People like me and I feel good about myself. Look, look, encourage yourself, program yourself, you will be the same. Remember, feed good, you will have good. Feed bad, you will have bad. So, we have situational self. For example, I'm going to enjoy going to work today. I will enjoy cooking today and have fun. Look, if you select to do something, enjoy it. Enjoy it and create positive attitudes and positive energy around you. Self-talk. So, you can self-talk here. You can create cycle of self-talk, whatever you want, and you will be really changing your life. And this is what I want to tell you. And this is our reference. No, I guess this is not the reference of this book. However, this is what I want to tell you today about what to say. When this is our reference, what to say, this is a book, what to say when you talk to yourself, or Shad Helmstetter. This is the author of this book, and I try to analyze this book for you. It's a very interesting book as well. Hopefully you learn from it and you create your own positive list and practice it. Do it in practice. Say to yourself in everyday life, and after a while you'll change completely. You'll be positive as you feed. And remember, feed positive, you'll have positive. Feed negative, you will receive negative.